Good morning, children. Today I will start with the new chapter, endocrine system. Now there are the parts in our body which secrete certain chemical substances, and these parts are called glands, glands. There are two types of glands in our body, the endocrine glands and the exocrine glands. The endocrine glands are called ductless glands, for these glands, they do not have ducts, tube-like structures called ducts, to carry their secretion to the target organ. They pour their secretion directly into the blood, and the blood carries it to the specific or target organ where this chemical substance has to act. These glands are called endocrine glands, which is the chapter that we are going to do. The other group of glands are called exocrine glands. Exocrine glands are duct bearing glands. They have proper ducts, D-U-C-T-S, to carry their secretions to the part concerned or the target organ. They are duct bearing glands called exocrine glands. For example, the tear gland, salivary gland, then the the gland that is like pancreas, the pancreatic duct is there. So these are all exocrine glands. Now, the chemical substance secreted by the endocrine glands are called hormones, and the chemical substances secreted by the exocrine glands are called enzymes. Now, see your books. Endocrine glands are these endocrine glands called ductless glands, the hormones that they secrete. That chemical substance, hormones, control, coordinate, then integrate, means forms a group to work together the various functions of the body by the secretion called hormones. These hormones with endocrine glands, they all together form a system called endocrine system. Now I'll repeat again. The function of the endocrine glands is they secrete the chemical substance called hormones, and these hormones, they regulate, they communicate, they integrate all the functional activities of the body so that the work in the body may take place at proper time and at the proper tuning. Now, for example, you'll find when the food reaches the stomach, then the gastric juice will be poured into the stomach to act on the food. So this is how the proper coordination, proper timing, proper tuning of the function is being controlled to the far extent by the nervous system and also by the endocrine system. They both work together in controlling, in regulating, in coordinating the various metabolic functions of the body. So the nervous system, we'll do it this chapter afterwards, performs the above functions by the conduction of nerve impulse. Nervous system, they control all the metabolic function by sending the messages called nerve impulse through the nerves to the brain, to the spinal cord, and get the work done accordingly. But the working alone or in contact with the endocrine system together, they form a system called neuroendocrine system. When the nervous system and endocrine system, they work together, then they form a system called neuroendocrine system. They perform the same general functions, but still they have some differences in their working. What are the differences? The nervous system, it works by the conduction of the nerve impulses, that is by carrying the messages Nerve impulse means the messages from the part of the body to the brain and spinal cord, and from brain and spinal cord to the part of the body to react. So they send the messages through the nerves, whereas endocrine system, they secrete the chemical messenger hormones. And these hormones, why they are called chemical messengers? Because they will carry a message to the target organ, and then that target organ will accordingly carry its function. Then this nervous system, the working is very fast. Immediately the stimulus is applied, the condition is applied, and the body react to it. Whereas the endocrine control system is a slow process. Nerve impulse, that is the messages through nerves, is conducted through the nerve fibers. Whereas in the endocrine control system, these are the hormones which will carry the messages through the bloodstream to the target organ. Effects of nerve impulses are short-lived. That is, the message sent through the nerves to the body parts or to the brain or spinal cord, they are too very short-lived. For the time being, the work has to be done and to be completed. They will act only to that extent, to that period only. Whereas this endocrine system, the hormones, when they will reach the target organ, they can get the work functioning of that body part to a prolonged, will produce a prolonged effect, a long effect it will be producing in that, and that part will function it accordingly for a long period of time. Then the information is directed in the nervous control, the information or message is directed to the specific part, whereas here the messages is being spread throughout the body because the blood is carrying the message. The hormones travels in blood, and hormones are the chemical messengers. So the blood is carrying the messages, the chemical messenger, and it is being spread throughout the body. But that hormone or chemical messenger will only act, will only make that target organ to work only. Though it is spread throughout the body, it will not show, it will have no effect on the other organs if it comes in touch with it. Only that hormone will be particular to that particular organ where it has to get the work done. So the hormones are specific in nature. Then we'll find it has no, the nervous system or the nervous control by the nervous system do not affect the growth of the body, whereas the hormones are responsible to affect the growth of the body also. Then these nervous control, they do not influence chemical changes and cannot regulate the body metabolism. They cannot control the basic body metabolism, that is the basic functions, breaking down of carbohydrate, protein, fats, and these all are being done by the endocrine control. The endocrine glands secrete very minute, very less quantities of chemical messengers called hormones. The hormones are released directly into the bloodstream. As there are no ducts in endocrine glands, hence called ductless glands, most hormones, despite their widespread distribution by the blood, are highly specific in their action. And cells that respond, that react to a particular hormone, those are called as target or organ cells. So these, the target organs or the target cells, are those which will react to the hormone concerned. The science concerned with the structure and function of endocrine glands, its diagnosis and treatment and disorder of endocrine glands is known as endocrinology. So all the parts concerned with the endocrine system, the endocrine glands, the hormones, then their effects, how they are harmful, what disorders they cause, all this we study in a branch of science called endocrinology. And the person dealing in this, specialized in this branch of science, are called, those doctors are called endocrinologists. Now, difference between endocrine and exocrine gland, this difference is important. The endocrine are ductless glands, they don't have ducts. These glands have ducts. They secrete, endocrine glands secrete a chemical substance called hormones, whereas the exocrine glands secrete enzymes or some other useful substances. Then the endocrine glands, their secretions, that is hormones, they always act away from the site of secretion. That is, for example, the pituitary gland is secreting a hormone which is present in the forehead of our brain, and that hormone will be carried by the blood, and its target organ will be its hormones will stimulate the thyroid glands to carry its function. So thyroid gland are present in the neck. They may stimulate the adrenal gland also to carry its function properly. So these adrenal glands are present near the kidneys. So the source organ is away from the target organ. Whereas the in exocrine gland, the secretions may act away or at the site of their secretions only. They may be carried to the target organ, or they may act then and there only. That is, the gastric juice is secreted from the inner walls of stomach and is poured there only to carry its function. They are not being carried away to far off place from its place of its secretion. Now, secretions are transported, that is, hormones are transported by the way of blood. And these are, there's the secretions, that is, enzymes are transported by the way of the ducts carry them. These are very fine tube-like structures. For example, from the gallbladder, the bile duct comes to the duodenum. So the bile juice travels through that duct. So the ducts are responsible to carry it and transfer it to the required part. Then the example of endocrine glands are pituitary gland, thyroid gland, adrenal gland. Pancreas also act as endocrine glands. Then here you will find the exocrine glands are sweat glands, salivary glands, sebaceous glands, and pancreas also act as exocrine. So pancreas is two in one. It acts as endocrine also, it acts as an exocrine gland also. When I will teach you in detail, then I will let you know how it is endocrine in nature and how it is exocrine in nature. So the chemical nature of hormones and the function of hormones I will be taking next time. Thank you.